when Defense Minister Avigdor Lieberman called to boycott Arab businesses in the Wadi Ara area Sunday, he appeared to have opened himself up to some legal troubles, but he probably doesn't need to be concerned after all. Israel has a law against boycotts, which allows their victims to open civil suits against individuals or groups calling for them, if the victims can prove damages. Be the first to know, join our Facebook page. Function, D, S, ID, var JS, FJS equal D get elements btag name, S, 0, if, D get element bid, ID, return, JS equal D createlement, S, JS dot ID equal ID, JSSRC equal slash slash connect facebook.net slash n underscore us slash all JS number XFBML equal 1 and app ID equal 163414806897, FJS parent node insert before, JS, FJS, document, script, Facebook JSSDK, in this law, boycott on the State of Israel means intentionally avoiding an economic, cultural, or economic connection with a person or other factor only because of their connection to the State of Israel, its institution or an area under its control, in order to harm it economically, culturally, or academically. The law reads, since Lieberman is calling to economically harm residents of an area under Israeli control, Wadi Ara, his call seems to fall under the bill's purview, even if its intention is to fight settlement boycotts and the anti-Israel boycott, divestment and sanctions movement. There is currently a bill by Likud MK Yoav Kish in the Knesset pipeline that would allow lawsuits without proof of damage, but it has not gone to a first reading yet despite the fact that his comments seem to fall under the category of a prohibited call to boycott. He probably won't face any personal consequences, because of his immunity. Parliamentary immunity in Israel shields lawmakers from civil or criminal responsibility or any legal action for the way they voted or expressed their opinion in speech or writing, or actions they took in the Knesset or outside it as part of their job. The same immunity has applied to ministers and deputy ministers, like Lieberman, who are not members of Knesset since 2015, when the mini-Norwegian law passed. That law allows one minister or deputy minister per party to resign in order to allow in a new MK, but if the person who resigned is fired from or leaves the government, he or she may return to the Knesset, and the new MK would have to leave. Amir Fuchs of the Israel Democracy Institute confirmed that Lieberman has the same immunity as any other Knesset member, meaning the boycott law would not work against him, but there is a different angle from which to tackle his comments. Immunity does not apply to cases of incitement to racism, which is a crime that was specifically exempted from the substantive immunity given to MKS and ministers, Fuchs said. In connection to Lieberman's statements, the matter stands before law enforcement authorities. The kinds or speech that are exempted from parliamentary immunity, if it is not random, are rejecting the existence of the State of Israel as the state of the Jewish people, rejecting the democratic character of the state, incitement to racism because of color or belonging to a race or national ethnic origin, and support for armed combat by an enemy state or acts of terror against the State of Israel or against Jews or Arabs because they are Jews or Arabs in Israel or abroad. However, the Supreme Court and Knesset Ethics Committee have usually given a very wide berth to MKS to make statements that some may consider to fall under those categories. Meanwhile, Joint List MK Taleb Abu Arar called for the Monitoring Committee of the Israeli Arab Leadership to meet to discuss Lieberman's statements and consider a class action lawsuit against the minister. The law pertaining to parliamentary immunity applies to all legal action because of actions in or for fulfilling his job as a member of Knesset, which would include class action suits. Abu Arar said Lieberman should take personal responsibility for the burden of his declarations calling to formally and economically disconnect from residents of Wadi Ara. He must pay the legal price for his hatred and calls of incitement against Arabs in Israel, the MK added. Share on Facebook, share on Twitter tags, Avigdor Lieberman, Jerusalem Arab Israeli, Donald Trump.